Infra Private Limited. Having its headquarters at Gurgaon, India's leading infrastructure services company with 3,150 employees, 175 offices, and in the industry for last 25 years with shareholders L&T, IDFC, HDFC, had been appointed as distribution franchisee on input-based incremental revenue-sharing franchisee model by SESU. Feedback Infra, having long-term vision in power, operation and maintenance business, incorporated 100% subsidiary company commonly known as FEDCO, Feedback Energy Distribution Company Limited, on 29th October 2012. Core team from Feedback Infra had been shifted to Orissa for initializing the operations. We have signed agreement on 6 January 2013 and then started operation on 1st February 2013. Our operational areas are electrical divisions of Puri, Khordha, Balugaon and Nayagarh. We are catering more than 4.5 lakh consumers with 10,800 square kilometer areas, which is predominantly rural. FEDCO has put in place a highly experienced team of managerial and operational expertise in the area of transmission and distribution. With dreams in eyes and passion to achieve, the team was built to start the journey towards attaining FEDCO's vision to be amongst the top 3 Indian energy distribution companies. FEDCO believes in building strong connections. All its efforts and activities are focused to understand, serve and connect with its consumers.
First of all, let me wish all my fellow colleagues at FEDCO a very warm and heartening congratulations for being a part of the FEDCO story. We are about to be 2 years old, and I thought this is the right moment for us to address each other. If I have to summarize from last year till this year, I am proud of a lot of things that you have done to enhance our reputation as a professional company. It's because of the way you work that our image of being a professional company is only getting enhanced. Today, our FEDCO employee strength is around 500 and our complete partner ecosystem resource strength is around 2000 plus. We have a very well-defined entry and exit processes. We have induction programs. That being the first part of what the human resources department was meant to do was to ensure that we get the right kind of people for the right position. We have identified 14 training themes, including technical, commercial, software issues, all of them together. And the plan is to train all our employees and a part of our partner company's employees also on these identified themes.
Employee engagement activities given another priority here, making them engaged, making them feel them that they belong to the organization with the entire inclusiveness environment.
It was a big challenge for us to set up different offices in different locations. However, within 2 months, we could successfully establish 50 offices in our 4 operational areas with all infrastructure and internet facility. We have deployed 105 vehicles in all our offices for the smooth operation purpose also. This year, we are also trying to redesign our offices for to make it better customer friendly.
We all know that the first 2 years of any distribution franchisee is the toughest when it comes to revenue returns. The 4 divisions are working very hard, but they still are not in a position to pump revenue in the system which we can spend. So we are dependent on external funding agency for our expenses. Our F&A team is involved in each of the operational process. I find this to be heartening because once they are involved in the process, the merit of allowing an expense or not allowing becomes far more superfluous for the operation team and for the F&A as well.
We have to first do budgeting, and based out of budgets, then projections comes out, the targets comes out, which we give to operations. Our targets are more towards cost break-even point of view. We have to first meet our cost, then make profit. And when you look from operations side of it, it starts more toward reduction of losses.
And I would like to tell you that one uniqueness in Nayagarh, only women SSGs are doing the meter and billing collection, which is itself is a record in whole of India, and nowhere in India the women SSGs are catering the whole district. And as a result, in the first year, with the help of the SSGs, we could able to bring down the AT&C loss by 7%, which itself is a record in CESU. And this year we have introduced a performance-based incentive, whereas we are paying about 7 to 10% extra incentive, but we are getting about 24% more collection, and they are doing a good result.
We can find a lot of discussion being held at nation level and nationwide, in fact, about women empowerment, but the reality is what we see here.
FEDCO pakhare ame nischit bhabre samaste ame bahut khushi kaam karikiri ebong samasta staff amar officer bunda.
I would still want all my colleagues at FEDCO to be a little bit more sensitive towards process adherence. I get to see quality team's report as well as our audit reports, and I feel there is a scope of improvement when it comes to process adherence.
FEDCO is a process driven company, hence quality assumes a very important role in the whole organization structure. And we have over here a structured quality approach. We have a quality team dedicated for the quality related activities. We have taken the major processes in terms of the operational performance for each of these parameters of all the processes, and we come to a quality score, and we also define a areas of improvement so that we can go for a 100% quality orientation in each of the processes. And our endeavor will eventually lead to a quality process driven FEDCO.
We would be the only franchisee implementing technology interventions of this nature. We have introduced ERP billing software across all our sections, subdivisions and divisions. We have identified 14 technology interventions to be adopted by our four divisions. This is an ongoing process. This has not ended. When I say 14, it is as of today. There will be a need to update the technology and update the initiatives as well.
Till now, we have implemented 14 technological initiatives. So, in which the GPRS-based SBM and online energy audit and new service connection tracker. These are the main initiatives which you can see.
We have introduced IR billing, that is infrared billing, which will continuously eliminate the manual intervention in single phase consumer billing. And also we have introduced AMR, automatic meter reading, for all our high value HT consumers. We have introduced AccuChecks for consumer meter testing at site, and we are also have a Zera very high quality reference standard meter for testing of our high value customers also.
The use of technology, while we have introduced a lot of concepts, I feel that we have not really implemented it as well. We all should know that the average age of FEDCO employees is around 30 years, which is the right age for technology. So we have to understand that the technology initiatives that we have embarked upon can only be successful if you own it.
Getting a new connection was never so easy. With FEDCO, it's less time consuming and hassle-free.
Our consumer service, our customer care is far, far, far more professional today than it was last year. We want to give a better consumer service. Customers should feel that this company is there to serve us better.
Any fuse call related issues are attended in a very short time. Once I make a call to call center.
My aim is to give prompt service. Generally, receiving complaints are immediately forwarded to field staff for resolution within limited time frame. The field staff will resolve the complaint and call to call center giving the feedback.
We have another important activity of calling out to the customer to understand the voice of the customer.
Our village, since a long time, had suffered from low voltage and power disruptions. FEDCO, in the past few months, have done major repairs and replacements in the network to improve the quality of power. These new types of AB cables have two major advantages. First, it is not easy to tamper for hooking, leading to better voltage, and second, it requires less maintenance. We are carrying out these capex activities at Sunarathi village, which will add around 70 new consumers to our network.
When our capex team sat around early February this year on how much capex to do in the year and where, after very detailed discussion, what came out was we should have an approach which will take care of two things: that our investments give us value on a shorter time frame. Second, it should improve the system reliability. We chose to take a distribution transformer wise approach.
In CapEx, we have followed DTR wise comprehensive approach. We have gone with the DTR meter, AB cable, DTR cable, AB cable, conductor replacement, and meter replacement.
In meter installations, we have set industry benchmarks by installing about 11,000 meters in a month. In first year of operations, FEDCO's performance is amongst the best in the industry, not only in Odisha, but pan-India as well.
We are investing around 48 crores in this particular financial year, and as of now, the loss reduction which we have seen, that is more or less equivalent to the planned loss reduction levels.
Procurement became our biggest challenge when we took over because of the quantum involved. So the first task that we did after takeover was to formulate a procurement guideline which was implemented from day one. And second was the formation of a procurement committee. There is a well outlined process of calling for tenders, negotiations, evaluations, and that has zero tolerance in our system.
In FEDCO, procurement of material is done very systematically. Each and every item is tenderized. Once we receive the quotes, then we go to the details of the reputation of the company, quality of the material, and ultimately among the best material, we get the lowest rate. And in this way, we have been procuring material since last year. Currently, we have got a central store as well as stores at the division. In fact, last year when there was a very severe cyclone Phailin, in spite of the extremely high demand in the market, our suppliers stood by us and we could get material like 4,000 poles in a 1 week's time.
Last year it was just Phailin, we were a bunch of very energetic people. People whose acceptance has started. The second foundation year is, it's a commitment. Yes, we can deliver. We are far more equipped. We are far more motivated. We are far more grounded. We know what is, why we are here and why, for whom we are here.
As an initiative, this year we have started vigilance activities. Since April, we are doing this vigilance activity across four divisions with the help of five teams. And it's a matter of pride to share with you all. Last month, we have achieved the highest collection.
The unauthorized users are booked under the Electricity Act and cases are registered at the police station.
Operational efficiency is to reduce AT&C losses, increase RPU, and to provide prompt and efficient consumer services. In first year, in terms of reduction of AT&C losses, we were not only amongst best in Odisha, but from similar examples across India as well. To sustain improvement in operational efficiency, FEDCO has introduced relevant technologies and redefined processes. To enable this, FEDCO, along with its partners, has 600 employees for commercial activities, 700 employees for O&M activities, and 500 employees for CapEx activities. We are having 250 Fuse call centers who attend more than 30,000 Fuse calls every month.
Therefore, we focused on mainly two important parameters, that is service to high value consumers and revenue protection.
Baluga being on the seashore, it is prone to cyclone related disasters, and me and my team are well prepared to handle this kind of natural calamities. We also in Baluga focus on addressing the issue of unauthorized uses of power, and we are taking various steps to bring it under control.
Working with women SAGs is a challenging job for us, as they are engaged for fully commercial activities. Our challenge is to increase in coverage, change of working styles of SAGs and skill upgradation of SAGs.
As far as the satisfaction of the consumers are concerned, we are regularly organizing bill revision camps and all, and we are also planning for enhance it to some more so that consumer will be satisfied.
This is my honest confession, this has been a really different experience. I see a lot of commitment, very, very professional and organized approach. That is what makes this company, the whole initiative, very special. Coming to FEDCO, what I have found is unique is their adaptability to new kind of systems, their concern for customer satisfaction, reducing consumer grievances, as well as using technology to improve its operational efficiency. I think in that direction, I think FEDCO is one of the three franchises which had adopted strategies for engaging technology as a tool in their day-to-day operations. They are also using various technology to improving their performances, monitoring their staff's performances. So in that respect, if you look at the last year performance also out of all three franchises, FEDCO has done well in all the four divisions where it is working.
FEDCO Seva, Social Engagement and Voluntary Activities Club at FEDCO. Money and the funds which we collected was from the employees, and we brought in some things which school children needed most, and the activities were conducted in the four divisions. So here we bought in school bags, pencils, and we distributed to the brightest children of those schools. Apart from focusing on schools and children, has been blood donation. So we have started to encourage regular blood donation drives among our employees.
I wish all my fellow colleagues the best of luck and hope that we can only get better from here. Thank you.
We are FEDCO.
I'm proud to be a part of the FEDCO family.